Welcome to this Angular Scheduler component tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to perform CRUD actions dynamically in the Angular Scheduler by customizing the Quick Info pop-up using a template. In this demo, I'll customize the Quick Info pop-up with a text box and button to add an event. To update or delete an event, I'll customize the pop-up with a text box and two buttons. First, I open my existing application where I've added the basic code to render the Angular scheduler. To learn more about integrating this scheduler component into an Angular application, please check the Getting Started video attached to the card above and the description below. I run this application using the ng-serve command. See, the scheduler component is rendered with the provided appointments. When I click a cell, the Quick Info pop-up renders like this. Let me show you how to customize the Quick Info pop-up using a template to add an event. First, I add the ng template and its reference, Quick Info Templates header. As I'm going to use the Syncfusion Angular button component in the Quick Info pop-up, I install the package by running the command ng add Syncfusion EJ2 Angular buttons. In the app module TS file, you can see the button module automatically imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular buttons package and injected into the imports array of the ng module. While installing the buttons package, some modules will be imported automatically. Since I only need the button module, I've removed the rest of the modules. In the header template, I add division tags with appropriate classes and a button tag with the EJSButton attribute. I set the class to eCloseIcons and title to close. Next, add a click event with the callback method on closeClick. I open the app component TS file and define the onCloseClick method. Before going further, I need to get the scheduler instance to access its built-in methods. So I add a reference to the scheduler component. In the app component TS file, I first need to import the ViewChild directive from the Angular core package. Then, using this ViewChild directive, I create the scheduler instance. Inside this method, I use the scheduler instance to call the built-in method closeQuickInfoPopUp. Then, customize the pop-up content by adding the ng template with the reference QuickInfoTemplatesContent. As I said earlier, I plan to use a Syncfusion Angular text box in the Quick Info pop-up, so install the package using the command ng add Syncfusion EJ2 Angular inputs. In the app module TS file, you will see the text box module automatically imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular inputs package and injected into the imports array of the ng module. While installing the inputs package, some modules will be imported automatically. Since I only need the text box module, I've removed the rest of the modules. I add the data context variable to the ng template to access the data source value. Next, I add the Angular text box component with a few basic options. I add the value property and access the subject field using the data context variable. In the styles CSS page, define the styles like background, padding, and more to align the pop-up header and content. At last, assign the Quick Info pop-up CSS class to the scheduler to align its pop-up. When I click the cell or existing event, you can see the customized pop-up. Next, I will show you how to add new events programmatically using an external button click. I add the ng template with reference quick info templates footer, then add the division element and the ng if condition to check whether the element type is cell. Add the button component with a few basic options to customize it. Then add the click event and assign the callback method on button click with event and ID add as arguments. I open the app component TS file and define the onButtonClick method. Inside this method, declare a variable QuickPopUp to get the QuickPopUp element. I import the closest method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package and then assign the QuickPopUp wrapper element using the closest method. Next, add an if condition to check whether the option is add. Then declare the variable subject and access the text box value using its instance. Next, declare the add object variable and assign event details like ID, subject, start time, end time, and is all day fields. Then pass this add object to the add event method using the scheduler instance. Finally, to close the pop-up, I call the onCloseClick method. Check now, when I click this cell, a quick pop-up will open where I enter the subject. Clicking this add button, new events will be added to the scheduler. Next, I will show you how to edit an event. To demonstrate this, I add another division element with the condition to check whether the element type is event. I change the button caption to save and change the click event callback method's second argument to edit. In the onButtonClick method, I add an else condition. Declare a variable event details and get the active cell details using the scheduler instance. Then I add a condition to check whether the option is edit and modify the subject from the event details using the text box instance. And pass this object to the save event method using the scheduler instance. I click this event, modify the subject. When I click the Save button, the event will be updated in the scheduler. You can also delete an existing event. To do so, add another button and change the caption to delete. I change the click event's callback method argument to delete. In the onButtonClick method, I add an else condition. Call the delete event method using the scheduler instance and pass the ID of the existing event. When this delete button is clicked, the existing event is deleted from the scheduler. In this video, I showed you how to perform CRUD actions dynamically in the Angular scheduler by customizing the quick info pop-up using a template. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.